Hi everyone, my name is Dmitry and welcome to my YouTube channel Electronics Manufacturing Technologies. And in this video I'll tell you about soldering flux classifications and a little bit about no clean fluxes. I will explain you why it's important to understand what type of soldering flux you are using. This is a crucial topic. Watch this video until the end and let's start it. There are several classes of soldering fluxes used in electronics industry: low activity, middle activity and high activity. To understand which soldering flux classificators on your soldering flux, please check its label or datasheet. And let me know in comments what type of soldering fluxes you are using, what classificators of your soldering fluxes. Many soldering fluxes sold on online marketplaces don't have any classificators. A lot of these soldering fluxes come from China, typically cheap with no name or with strange name, and their manufacturers and characteristics really unknown. Many brands use term no clean, but this is misleading and doesn't provide any information. No clean doesn't mean anything, just possible no clean properties. All is simple, most cheap soldering fluxes must be thoroughly cleaned. This flux can remain active after soldering. It means that your repaired electronics may start oxidizing, or even faster when exposed to operating current. This leads to another issue: how well can you clean these residues from under the components? And there is no guarantee. You need to be certain that soldering flux residues will not cause oxidation after soldering. To ensure this, you should use high quality soldering fluxes, soldering pastes that have clearly defined classifications. Only no clean sign doesn't tell us about soldering flux classification. If the classificators is labeled, like RL0, REL0, ORL0, this is truly no clean. If the classificators ends in 1, like here, this flux must be cleaned. Soldering fluxes with 1 in the end contain active components and halides that promote oxidation and current leakage. If the third letter of the classifications M or H, it means that flux is active and must be cleaned. This is critical that in third letter M or H and must be fully washed out from under the components or oxidation can occur. Always use quality soldering fluxes with a clear classification. Don't use strange no names, cheap Chinese soldering fluxes or soldering pastes. You might ruin your work. Future repairing will cost much more than you buying quality soldering flux or soldering paste. Here's a classification table for different soldering flux types. The first two letters indicate the base on which the soldering flux are made. First, RO, resin based. Second, RE, synthetic resin based. Third, OR, organic based, water or alcohol based. The third letter in the classifications defines the soldering flux activity level: L, low, M, medium, H, high. Only RL0, REL0 and ORL0 are considered no clean. Organic fluxes ORL0 and ORL1 are more common in industrial use because they are easy to clean with water-based washing system. The last digit 0 or 1 in the abbreviation refers to the amount of halides in the soldering fluxes. 0 means halide free, 1 contain halides. Last digit directly impacts how well the soldering flux removes oxide films from PCB parts and components during soldering. 1 indicates stronger oxidized removal properties. When using active fluxes classified as 1 or containing M or H, you might ensure proper cleaning. If active flux residues remain on PCB under components under microchips, oxidation will begin in coming months and your device will be covered white or gray oxides. For new PCBs and components, it's the best to use RL0 like this. RL0 soldering fluxes with low activity. RL0 are sufficient for most soldering and repairing work. If PCB parts covered slight oxidation, you can use M or H in third letter soldering flux with middle or high activity. This provides better oxide removals and improve solder joint quality. But don't forget about cleaning after soldering this flux M and H. High activity soldering fluxes used in mass production where very small SMD components soldering. They ensure complete soldering of all parts on PCB and all components, especially if they're modern PCB. Medium activity, high activity and soldering fluxes with 1 in the end must be fully washed out after soldering. I have a special video about soldering flux cleaning. You can watch it after this one. And right now is a very important point. Unwashed flux residues can change own resistance when PCB board is heating, microchips is heating, components is heating. If the microcircuit heat up during operation, the soldering flux residues can start conduct electricity. This will cause failures and short circuits in IC operation. Remember this and try to wash off absolutely any soldering fluxes. One more interesting point. Many manufacturers still use term RMA. This is old abbreviation. It is mostly used as a marketing trick because people recognize it. The correct modern classifications for RMI is ROM 0. My recommendation for manual and automated soldering, use ROM 0 classifications for soldering fluxes and soldering pastes. The flux form, liquid or paste, doesn't matter. Use what you need. Final tip, always clean your PCB board after soldering from soldering flux residues because dust and other particles can stick to PCB board and can cause current leakage. I hope this video helped to understand soldering flux classificators. Let me know in the comments what you think about this video. Like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, turn on notification. In description of this video you can find links to my Instagram, my Telegram group, to my website with soldering fluxes, to my website with search system for electronic industry manufacturers. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.